हेलो माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल. सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर ऑलरेडी टेकिंग द क्लासेस ऑन गूगल मीट ऐप, बट मैनी ऑफ द पेरेंट्स दे वर आस्किंग मी टू मेक यूट्यूब वीडियोज सो दैट यू पीपल कैन रिवाइज द चैप्टर्स. सो हेयर आई एम बैक अगेन विद द न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर थर्ड ऑफ योर बुक हनी सर्कल, तारोज रिवॉर्ड. सो लेट्स बिगिन द चैप्टर. बिफोर यू रीड, दिस इज अ स्टोरी अबाउट अ thoughtful and loving son. He works hard to fulfill his parents' wishes and gets some unexpected help. So this story is about a boy whose name is Taro, and Taro is a very thoughtful and loving son. Thoughtful means very caring or very understanding, and Taro works hard to fulfill all the wishes of his parents, and one day what happens, he gets some unexpected help. So what kind of help he gets, we will read in this chapter. So let's come to the first paragraph. Okay, first I want to tell you that reward means a prize. So what kind of prize he gets in this chapter, we will see. So a young woodcutter named Taro lived with his mother and father on a lonely hillside. So there was a young woodcutter whose name was Taro, and he used to live with his mother and father on a lonely hillside, on a hill area. All day long he chopped wood in the forest. So what work he used to do? He used to chop wood in the forest. Chop means to cut into pieces. And though he worked very hard, he earned very little money. So Taro used to work very hard. He used to chop wood all day long, but he earned very little money. So he was basically poor. He did not have much money to fulfill his parents' wishes. So this made him sad, for he was a thoughtful son and wanted to give his old parents everything they needed. So because he was not having sufficient money, so this thing always used to make him sad, because he was a very caring son and he wanted to help his parents in every way, and he wanted to buy everything which they needed, but because of the lack of money he was not able to buy the things. That why he always used to get sad. One evening when Taro and his parents were sitting in a corner of their hut, a strong wind began to blow. So one evening they all were sitting in their hut, Taro and his parents, and suddenly what happened, a strong wind started blowing and it whistled through the cracks of the hut, and everyone felt very cold. Whistle through means, the meaning is given, you can see students, pass through with a whistling sound. Basically it means to make a whistling sound, okay. So the wind, it was a very strong wind and it entered through the cracks of the hut. And that's why the parents, they started feeling very cold, especially the father of Taro, he started feeling very cold. Suddenly, Taro's father said, "I wish I had a cup of sake. It would warm me and do my old heart good." So Taro's father, he started feeling cold and suddenly he said that, "I wish I had a cup of sake." Sake means a Japanese alcoholic drink, and people drink it and in winter, and it keeps them warm. So that's why his father wanted to have that drink, sake, so that he can feel warm, because he was feeling cold due to the strong cold wind. This made Taro sadder than ever, for the heartwarming drink called sake was very expensive. So when Taro heard the wish of his father, he became sadder, he became more sad, because this heartwarming drink called sake was very expensive and he did not have much money to buy sake. How do I earn more money? He asked himself. This boy Taro, he started thinking that how to get more money, how to earn more money. How do I get a little sake for my poor old father? He decided to work harder than before, and he wanted to buy sake for his poor old father. So what he decided? He decided to work harder so that he can earn more money and he can buy sake for his father. एक्सपेंसिव मीन्स कॉस्टली द मीनिंग इज गिवन यू कैन सी स्टूडेंट्स आई कम टू द नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग तारो जम्प्ड आउट ऑफ बेड अर्लियर देन यूजुअल एंड मेड इज वे टू द फॉरेस्ट सो नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग व्हाट हैपेंड तारो गॉट अप अर्ली एंड ही स्टार्टेड मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द फॉरेस्ट अर्लियर देन हिज यूजुअल टाइम He chopped and cut as the sun climbed and soon he was so warm that he had to take off his jacket. So he reached the forest and he started chopping the wood and he chopped the wood without stopping and the sun also climbed. The sun also appeared and he started feeling warm because of the sunlight and then he had to take off his jacket. He took off his jacket. His mouth was dry and his face was wet with sweat. So, because he was chopping wood in the sunlight, so he was feeling thirsty also. His mouth was getting dry and his face was covered with sweat. My poor old father, he thought, if only he was as warm as I. So he started thinking about his father, that his father is very old and that's why he feels very cold. And then he started imagining him that what if his father was as warm as I, then there would have been no problem. And with that, he began to chop even faster, thinking of the extra money he must earn to buy the sake to warm the old man's bones. And then after that thought, he started working again and he started chopping the wood even faster because he wanted to earn extra money so that he can buy sake for his old father. Then suddenly Taro stopped chopping. What was that sound he heard? Could it possibly be rushing water? So suddenly what happened? He stopped chopping the wood because he heard a sound and he thought that it was the sound of rushing water. The sound was looking like the sound of a rushing water. Rushing means running water. Taro could not remember ever seeing or hearing a rushing stream in that part of the forest. Then Taro thought about it and he could not remember that there was any stream or river in the forest. He was thirsty. The axe dropped out of his hands and he ran in the direction of the sound. So, because he was thirsty, so he started moving towards the stream from where the sound was coming and the axe dropped out of his hands. Axe is a sharp instrument through which you cut the wood. So, the axe also dropped out of his hands and then he started moving towards the sound. Taro saw a beautiful little waterfall hidden behind a rock. So, what Taro observed? He observed a beautiful little waterfall that was hidden behind a rock. Kneeling at a place where the water flowed quietly, he cupped a little in his hands and put it to his lips. Kneeling means to bend down. So he bent down there at a place where the water was flowing quietly, where the speed of the water was not very high. And then he took some of the water from the waterfall in his hands and he tasted the water. Was it water or was it sake? He tasted it again and again. And always it was the delicious sake instead of cold water. So when he tasted the water of that waterfall, so it was not like water. The taste was not like that of water, but it was that of sake. So he started tasting it again and again just to confirm that it was sake, not the water. So it was actually sake, not the water. Delicious means tasty. Taro quickly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. Pitcher means a large jug or a pot which is made of mud. So Taro, what he did? He filled the pitcher which he had and then he moved towards his home. The old man was delighted with the sake. Who is the old man here? The father of Taro. He was very much delighted. Delighted means he was very much happy when he got the sake. Okay, you can see the picture also, students. There is a man, this man Taro, and he has a large jug also a large pot, and he is taking a water from the waterfall and he is trying to taste it. Okay, so after only one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. So after just tasting the sake, the old man, he was very happy and he stopped shivering. When you feel cold, you start shivering. Shivering means your body shakes. So his shivering was stopped and he was very happy and he started dancing on the floor, in the middle of the floor. That afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. Taro's father politely offered her a cup of the sake. So that afternoon only, a neighbor came to their house and Taro's father offered a cup of sake to that lady. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. So the lady drank the sake greedily. Greedily means as if desiring more and more. When you want something, more and more, okay? And thanked the old man. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall. And after that, Taro told that lady the story of that magic waterfall. Thanking them for the delicious drink, she left in a hurry. And then what the lady did? She thanked them for the sake and she left from there in a hurry. Very quickly, she moved out of the house. By nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. And by the night, she told the story to all the villagers. That evening, there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter's house. Procession means a crowd, a large crowd. Okay. So, all the villagers, they came to Taro's house that evening. Each man heard the story of the waterfall and took a sip of the sake. And all the villagers, when they appeared, they were offered sake by Taro and his father, and they took a sip of the sake. In less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. So the large jug, which was filled with sake, it got emptied in less than an hour. Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. So next morning, Taro again got up early and he started for work. He started moving towards the forest even earlier than the previous morning. He carried with him the largest pitcher he owned, for he intended first of all to go to the waterfall. Intended means planned, okay? So what he did, he carried the largest pitcher he had in his house because he had this plan in his mind that he will go to the waterfall and he will fill his pitcher. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. So when he reached to the waterfall, what he found, that all the villagers were there. They were carrying pitchers, jars, buckets, anything they could find to hold the magic sake. And they were, all the villagers were having their utensils like pitchers, jars, buckets, so that they can fill their utensils with the magic sake. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. So out of those villagers, one villager, he knelt there. He knelt means to sit on your knees. So he knelt there and held his mouth under the water to drink. So he tried to taste the water. He drank again and again and then shouted angrily, "Water, nothing but water." So when he drank the water, when he tasted the water, it was not tasting like sake. It was just like water. So he started shouting very angrily that it is just water. It is not sake. Others also tried, but there was no sake, only cold water. So other villagers, they also tried to taste it. They also drank the water. But for them also, it was just the cold water, not the sake. So you can see the picture. There are a lot of villagers. They are having their utensils. They are having their buckets, pitcher, jugs. And there is a large crowd, a huge crowd near the waterfall. And Taro is hidden behind the rock and he is seeing the villagers. So then what happened? "We have been tricked," shouted the villagers. "Where is Taro? Let us drown him in this waterfall." So when the villagers tasted the water and it was just the cold water for them. So they thought that Taro has tricked them. Trick means cheated. Deceived means cheated. Okay. So they thought that Taro had told lie to them and he had cheated them. So they started searching for Taro because they wanted to drown Taro in that waterfall only. But Taro had been wise enough to slip behind a rock when he saw how things were going. He was nowhere to be found. So because Taro, he already saw that there were a lot of villagers and he knew about the situation. So he hid himself behind a rock and the villagers were not able to find him. Muttering their anger and disappointment, the villagers left the place one by one. Muttering means speaking unclearly. So they started muttering in anger and disappointment and the villagers left that place one by one. They all moved out of that place. Taro came out from his hiding place. Was it true? He wondered. Then he was watching the whole situation. So he was wondering that whatever happened with the villagers, was it true or not? Was the sake a dream? Once more, he caught a little liquid in his hand and put it to his lips. It was the same fine sake. So he tried to taste the water of that waterfall again. And when he tasted, it was the same fine sake for him. But for the villagers, it was the cold water. To the thoughtful sun, the magic waterfall gave the delicious sake. To everyone else, it gave only cold water. So to this very caring and loving sun, very thoughtful sun, the magic waterfall gave tasty sake, delicious sake. And to everyone else, it gave only cold water. Why? Because everyone else was greedy. They came there out of greed. Whereas Taro came to the waterfall because he wanted to help his parents. The story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached the Emperor of Japan. So this story of Taro, it reached to the Emperor of Japan and he sent for the young woodcutter and rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold for having been so good and kind. So he sent some of his servants to call this young woodcutter, means Taro, and he rewarded him. He gave him some prize. What he gave? He gave 20 pieces of gold. And why he gave? Because Taro was so good and kind. Then he named the most beautiful fountain in the city after Taro. And the most beautiful fountain in the city of that emperor, it was named after Taro only. This, said the emperor, was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents. And the fountain was named after the name of Taro just to encourage all the other children so that they also honor and obey their parents. They also respect their parents. So students, the chapter is finished. I hope you like the story and you have understood the chapter. And this is a Japanese story retold. Okay, so this is basically a Japanese story which has been translated into English for you people. So what is the moral of the story? What message do you get? So basically the message of the story is that you should always be respectful to your parents. You should always obey your parents. So I'll see you in the next video, students. You read this chapter and try to understand it. You can comment in the comment section below if you have any doubt and I'll answer you. Take care. Bye-bye.